Hi guys, my name is David from Pay It Forward.
And I'm David from Pay It Forward.
And in this video, we're going to show you what to do when your iPhone is frozen. No, not that type of frozen, when the software is frozen. In fact, 99% of the time when your iPhone is frozen, it's a software issue.
Mm-hmm. And the first thing we're gonna do is try to get your iPhone unfrozen. So the way we're gonna do that is to do a hard reset. So it's a little bit different for an iPhone 6S and before and an iPhone 7 and later. Now on an iPhone 6S and previous models, you're gonna hold down the power button and the home button together until the Apple logo appears in the screen. The screen will go black first. Apple logo appears, let go. I have an iPhone 7, so an iPhone 7 or newer models, we're gonna hold down the power button and the volume down button together.
Yep.
Until the screen turns black first, and then the Apple logo appears in the screen. Right about now.
Wow.
Pretty good.
Impressive.
Yep. And then let go. And your iPhone will turn back on. So if the iPhone was frozen, it means that there's some sort of a problem, usually a software problem. And so we want to back up your iPhone as soon as possible.
Yep. And we're going to link you to an article that'll show you how to do that in the upper right-hand corner of the screen.
Mm-hmm. So connect your iPhone to iCloud and back it up that way, or to iTunes on your computer. Let's save your data. And the next thing we're doing is we're going to assume that it's a software problem, because it probably is. And we want to identify whether it's one individual app that's causing the problem or if it's the entire iPhone operating system.
Correct.
And I should just mention that the severity of this problem varies a lot from person to person. Some people will turn in their iPhone and it will freeze right away. They can't get past the lock screen, can't even get into their iPhone. Other people will be going along just fine for a couple days. Their iPhone crashes, it freezes. Either way, after the hard reset, they really should back up their iPhone and do some deeper troubleshooting.
Yep.
Yeah, because it's sort of indicative of a larger problem, and it's like putting a Band-Aid on a wound.
Yes.
Not a good idea.
A serious wound.
It's coming back. You're going to have problems down the line. So the first thing we're going to do is identify if it's an individual app that's causing the problem. So to do that, we're going to go to Settings. We're going to scroll down to Privacy, and then head towards the bottom of this menu to Analytics. And then tap Analytics Data. Now, I don't expect anybody to be able to read iPhone logs that are complicated, but what I do want you to do is just go through this list and see if you see the name of any one app listed over and over and over again, especially if it's listed next to latest crash.
Yep.
Now, David's iPhone happens to be in excellent condition.
Yeah, I have a great iPhone for sure.
He does, yep. And so if you see an app listed over and over again, that app could have a problem and that could be causing your iPhone to crash.
Right.
Or to get frozen.
But if it's not an app, what's next?
The next thing we're going to do is, we should mention what happens if it's Safari.
Yes, well, that's a pretty common problem. People are browsing Safari and all of a sudden, frozen.
Yeah, Safari's frozen. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna erase the Safari data by going to
Settings.
Settings,
Scroll down and you're gonna wanna tap Safari.
Mm-hmm.
Scroll down again and tap Clear History and Website Data.
Yep, that's just gonna wipe out all your tabs, all your history, all the data from Safari, because sometimes websites can cause problems that cause iPhones to crash.
So just tap Clear History and Data, and boom.
Yep, and if you did find a problem with a specific app, what I'd recommend doing is either delete that app, maybe you reinstall it from the App Store, or if you can, see if you can find
just
an alternative.
Just find an alternative app.
Right, because a lot of times older apps haven't been updated in a while, can cause problems that cause iPhones to freeze.
So no app problems at all. Mm-hmm. What's next?
Well, if it isn't caused by a specific app, then we have to look at the entire iPhone operating system. So let's go to Settings and down to General and scroll to the bottom, tap Reset, and then tap Reset All
Reset
Settings.
Reset All Settings. Enter your passcode, hit the confirmation. I'm not going to do it here.
Yeah, because Reset All Settings is a sort of a, it's kind of like a magic bullet. It doesn't fix every problem, but it can resolve hidden problems with the iPhone operating system and with apps themselves. And it doesn't delete any of your data, your text messages, or your photos or anything, but it does require you to set up some of the things that are in settings, like your Wi-Fi password and your wallpaper.
Yep.
So we don't do that first, but it's something that's necessary.
So I reset all settings. My iPhone is still freezing pretty constantly. What's next?
Yeah, we need to restore your iPhone.
Yep.
So we're going to recommend a DFU restore.
Yeah, DFU restore. Now, if you don't know how to do it, we're going to link you to a video where we walk you through the whole process step by step, and that's in the card up above and the description down below.
You should back up your iPhone before a DFU restore or any restore, because it takes everything off your iPhone, and then you'll need to restore from a backup. Now, what I should mention is that if you DFU restore your iPhone and then restore from an iTunes or iCloud backup and it starts freezing all over again, there could be an issue within the backup that's causing this big software problem. So you'd have to DFU restore your iPhone again and then set it up as a new iPhone. That doesn't mean that you can't sign into iCloud and download your contacts and your calendars. That's fine. Do all that. Just don't restore from the backup itself. So you will have to re-download your apps. I know it's kind of a pain in the butt, but sometimes that's what we have to do.
That's what you have to do. I mean, stop your iPhone from freezing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's what you have to do. So we did the DFU restore.
Hardware
still gets frozen.
Right. Occasionally, and there can be issues or times when hardware problems can cause your iPhone to freeze. And usually it's after something like water damage or physical damage. Yeah. For instance, if an iPhone gets wet, you drop it in the pool. It's not an iPhone 7 or one of the waterproof ones. The camera gets damaged. You open the camera app, your iPhone freezes because the iPhone software needs to be able to talk to the hardware to work correctly. If something's wrong with the hardware itself, your iPhone software says, hey, let's talk, and then nothing happens.
So if you're under warranty, Apple Store?
Apple Store is a great option. If you're not under warranty...
There's Cell Savers, but they're changing their name in about a week to something else. We don't know.
Yeah, they won't.
But either way, we're going to link you to their website up above and in the description below.
Right. Cell Savers is a great company. They come to you to fix your iPhone in 60 minutes or less a lot of the time. Lifetime warranty, cheaper than Apple. And really, they do great work. So whatever they're called now, we recommend them.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So that's what you do when your iPhone is frozen. Mm-hmm. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any other questions, leave them down below in the comment section. Thumbs up this video if it helped you out. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for the best iPhone content on YouTube.